The three main features of object-oriented programming are encapsulation, inheritance, and polymorphism. We have seen the first two. Now let's see what is polymorphism. The meaning of this word polymorphism is the ability to take many forms. In programming, this means the ability of code to take different forms depending on the type with which it is used. Let us understand this with the help of an example. We have this function doSomething that has this parameter x. Inside this function, these two methods are called on x. We know that Python is a dynamically typed language. There are no type declarations. So the type of this parameter x is not declared. We can send any type of object to this function. We could send a list object or a string object, but then we'll get error in that case because the string type and list type do not support these methods move and stop. So this function will work correctly as long as we send objects of those types that support these two operations. Now let's go to idle. We have defined these three classes here. All these three classes have defined the methods move and stop, and the implementation is different in each one of them. For this class car, move prints car is running and stop prints brakes applied. For a clock, move prints this and stop prints this. And in this person class, move prints this and stop prints this. Then we have created these three instance objects, and this is the function that we have just seen in the slide. Now let's run this. Now we'll call this function doSomething one by one for each of these instance objects. So first we are sending this car instance object, and we get this output. Now let's send this clock instance object. We get this output. Now we'll send the person instance object. And we get this output. So any object that supports these two operations, move and stop, can be sent to this function. And the behavior of move and stop depends on the type of the object that they are operating upon. This is polymorphism. The same code can take different forms. So while executing this code, Python does not care about the type of x. Any object that supports these two methods will work regardless of its specific type. Python is not concerned about what an object is. It just needs to know what an object does. Let's see another example. We have these three classes named rectangle, triangle, and circle. And all these three classes have the methods named area and perimeter. And all of them have a class variable called name. In this rectangle class, we have these two instance variables, length and breadth, and the area is calculated by multiplying these two and perimeter by this formula. In this class triangle, we have these three instance variables which represent the three sides of the triangle. Area is calculated using Heron's formula and perimeter is calculated by adding these three sides. In the circle class, there is only one instance variable, which is the radius of the circle, and area is pi r square. And perimeter is 2 pi r. We have created two instance objects of each class. And here is our polymorphic function. So this function takes a parameter, prints the attribute name, and calls these methods area and perimeter. Now let's run this. So first we call this function with this parameter t2, which is a triangle. So we got this output. Now let's call this function with this parameter c1. Now we got this output. Now we call this function with this parameter r2, which is a rectangle. So we got this output. So we can see that this code could take different forms depending on the type of shape. Now suppose we have a list of objects. So we have this list of these instance objects, and we want to find out the total area and perimeter of all the shapes in this list. So first we take these two variables, total area and total perimeter, and initialize them to 0. Now in this loop, we are iterating over this list and calling the area and perimeter methods on each object. And after that, we are printing the total area and total perimeter. So this is again polymorphism. Let's run this. So we get the total area and total perimeter of all the shapes in this list. Now, other object-oriented languages might need these classes to be derived from a common base class to exhibit this polymorphic behavior. However, in Python, there is no such restriction. Polymorphism does not depend on inheritance. For polymorphism to occur, you just need to define different classes which have commonly named methods. Python's polymorphism is based on duck typing, which comes from the old saying, if it walks like a duck and quacks like a duck, then it is a duck. So different objects that have common method names can be treated in the same general way. Let us see some benefits of polymorphism. You can write generic code that can work with objects of different classes. When this generic code is run, Python uses polymorphism to call the correct method for each instance object. Polymorphism makes your code concise and flexible and provides a sort of abstraction. When writing the generic code, programmer need not think about the specific classes that will use the code. The code becomes very easy to update also. You can easily add new types. The functions that are already written can work with new types that you define in future, as long as those new types support the required operations. For example, in future, you could add a rhombus class with area and perimeter methods, and you can easily use it with the polymorphic code that we have seen in IDLE. Then the behavior shown by overloaded operators is also polymorphism. The overloaded operator takes different forms depending on the type it is operating upon. For example, this function can take different forms depending on the type of objects A and B. It will work correctly for objects of any type that support addition and multiplication.